think for a second about all the things we carry with us that could let people know who we are. Our wallets, our driver's license, our phones.
But what if you died and didn't have those items on you and nobody knew who you were? Wouldn't you want people to find out and let your family know?
Well, tonight we're digging deeper into a story of a group of passionate internet sleuths who solved a case like that in Southwest Florida involving this hiker. But I'm getting you more, hiking the trail myself, to explain why some wish they hadn't. I'll tell you right off the bat, this is a complicated story. A story of a man who didn't want anyone to know who he was, and a group of people fixated on finding out who he was. Let's take a walk, and I'll walk you through it. And we're gonna start where this man's life ended, right here in Collier County.
We just found a dead body.
Hikers had found the man dead back in summer of 2018.
Yeah, it's in a tent.
A tent at Big Cypress National Preserve. He was 83 pounds, emaciated. No ID, no credit cards, no phone, just supplies and nearly $4,000 in cash. He had wasted away here, alone. And the Collier County Sheriff's Office did not know who this guy was. There were no fingerprints in any system anywhere. There was no tattoos, no dental work. This guy was a ghost. So the Sheriff's Office asked for help. And I will say that's the one thing that was not in short supply in this case.
I was utterly captivated immediately.
It started small and then it snowballed.
I just sort of got sucked in.
Towards the end, I would say it was like a full-time job almost.
You're gonna meet all three of those people on our hike today because like so many, they became fixated on this case after the Collier County Sheriff's Office released a sketch of this man and people like Kelly Fairbanks said, yes, I know that hiker.
Huge smile, friendly eyes. He answered all the questions I had.
She had talked to him in Crestview, Florida, up in the Panhandle. Hikers had said he'd called himself mostly harmless, said he was from Louisiana, told them he had worked in New York City, but he never said his name, and he didn't have a phone.
Hey, did you meet mostly harmless when he came through? Hey, that's, you know, hiking with no cell phone.
He was mysterious, charming, inquisitive, friendly.
That is Nicholas Thompson, who wrote this piece about the mysterious hiker for Wired. He was fixated on finding out who Mostly Harmless was. His piece sparked a woman named Natasha Teasley, who led this Facebook group dedicated to figuring it out. She was fixated.
Because there was a lot of people who were really, really heart invested in the case, you know, like they cared so much.
They were fixated. The Facebook group's biggest contribution, they got a DNA company in Texas called Othram involved. Othram used DNA markers to confirm a really big clue about Mostly Harmless.
He probably had family in Louisiana, that he was likely Cajun, and that began to start to put some clues together.
Then there was another clue.
The notebook of computer programming.
Jason Nark wrote The Ghost in the Tent about Mostly Harmless. He was fixated, especially after reading these pages and pages Mostly Harmless had written. Were they personal diaries, personal thoughts? No. They were notes about a computer game that Mostly Harmless liked called Screeps. So, he was a Cajun computer genius. They may have been fixated, but that's still about all they knew.
He sort of becomes a cipher that you can sort of dump all your own personal feelings into.
I would get messages that said, this guy seems like my brother. He seems like my long-lost friend.
I thought he was going to be like a boring, regular person.
We're going to find out who this guy is for his family.
That's why everyone worked so hard to solve this mystery, to ID this guy right here, to try to let his family know what had happened. And that dragged on for 2 years. Until it ended. A woman in Louisiana saw his picture and recognized him. Mostly Harmless had a name, Vance Rodriguez. And he did have a story.
I think Vance Rodriguez decided he didn't want to be Vance Rodriguez anymore.
Because, well, Mostly Harmless had gotten along with everybody on the trail. Vance Rodriguez had struggled to do the same thing with the people closest to him off the trail. He'd had a falling out with his parents, was not close to family, relationship struggles, exes accused him of abuse. On the trail, Mostly Harmless was mysterious, charming, inquisitive, friendly.
And then we found out who he was, and suddenly, Well, actually, the words that came to mind were different. He was estranged. He was difficult. He was hostile. He was lonely. He was a very different person from the guy that many people had hoped to find.
But he was found. That his family didn't seem terribly interested was not the sheriff's office concern. So they closed the case.
I told you this was a complicated story. There was some good. Instead of tearing each other apart, people on the internet came together to try to do what they thought was right. Figure out who this man was and let his family know that he was gone. But in the end, Mostly Harmless had wandered into these woods to leave behind who he was. And his family didn't seem to care too much that he was gone.
Many questions remain. Why did Mostly Harmless start hiking? Why did he let himself waste away despite having money and a big highway just miles away? We will likely never know those answers, though we do now know his name.